My pieces are the model trains. I paint those with dry brush and wet brush techniques, and then the graffiti part of it is done with toothpicks dipped in acrylic ink, so it takes a couple hours, but they're pretty fun to do. The pieces that say, they're 8x24s that say love, strength, focus, and dream, those are repeated. I had a different idea for the show, but I got asked to do the graffiti piece. And then my brother in law and nephew remember the badass, and those pieces got changed around to kind of help me kind of deal with that, because that happened right after I got asked to do the show. So I was really stoked to do this, and then that was a big bummer, and I thought, you know, kind of just going to have some fun with it. And then the abstract pieces on the sidewall, those are just my take on Vancouver Island, sunrise and sunset, so like color and stuff. And the plinth, the big wall plinth, I got to paint that on Monday afternoon for about 2.5-3 hours to paint. Kind of make it look messy and colorful like the rest of our work. It looked fun. My background, I've been involved with graffiti since I was probably mid 80s, I was around 9 or 10 in one form or another, and then as I got older, I started channeling into canvas work, modern work, maybe portraits as well, but the show specifically, I just want to have some fun, kind of think back to when I was a kid. Bright colors, lots of fun. Any other questions you guys have? Just ask me.
Yes, that's right. And you were involved in a wonderful program with young people. I wondered if you talked about that.
There's two that I do. One is not really a program, it's called Sketching Thursdays. When I moved here, I didn't know anybody. And me and my husband were like, well, let's go draw somewhere. So we just put on Instagram and said, hey, I'm going to be at this spot because I'm drawing. If anyone wants to come out. And then one person came. So forth. And then one day his mom showed up at a gallery show we had, and she was like, my son, I'm going to graffiti, but I don't want him, like, I'd rather him kind of learn a little bit the right way about it and like some of the positive stuff. So, like, you have stuff in the galleries or like kind of room, just a little discussion. And at first, I was like, I don't really want kids here. I don't want to do this. Like, I'm not going to tell them yes or no. I'm not going to be the parent. I don't want this. So I talked to them. Like, they come to draw, and that's it. They want to ask about drawing techniques, things like that, no problem. So then one kid came, and then I told everyone else I was there. When the kid shows up, we're trying to figure out language a little bit. And then, like, we'll just see how this goes. So then one kid came, and another kid came. And then the kids, not even kids, like young adults that I was drawing with, because they're in range. I'm usually the oldest, they're in my 40s. And then there's kids coming that are as young as 6 that show up. So there's little groups, some are in like 10 to 13-ish, some are like maybe like 18 to 24-ish, and then there's a batch of oldies like me. And when the younger kids came, some of the young adults, those were their mentors that they were looking up to, so the new spots for something for me, like they're really from pass it down. So that's been going on almost 2 years now. It's hit or miss, because if you don't sign up for it, just show up, and if you want to draw. That's about it. And then the other thing is I teach little lettering classes on how to paint those model trains. And a lot of times those will be kids with their parents. So the parents will sit down with their kids and they'll each do a train together.
That's kind of fun. How do you find that in
there?
Facebook? Is it? Well, no, where would we find what you're doing here?
Oh, the sketch night is every Thursday is at QP Bakery in Chinatown from 6 to 8. So tonight the sketch night is canceled, so I've got some people that come to sketch night that came here and stuff.
Okay, sorry, where in Chinatown?
QP Bakery. It's right on Government in Pittsburgh, across from the Starbucks. Okay. So it's a small bakery. They're really chill there. They don't enforce my policies, so if you come sit down at Good Road, there's no problem. And it's just as much as you can, so if you show up and there's no space, of course you can grab it up. Sometimes there's no one there, sometimes there's like 3
people.
Yeah, it's good on. And then the classes for the
Yeah. why I make the art that I do, how I became inspired, and why that fits into this. So I was born on the island, in Nanaimo, actually. And I grew up in a household where my grandmother was an artist and my mother studied art history. So I had a lot of the great beginnings of being nurtured into a world where it was a possibility for me to be able to create. And there was always the push of, well, why don't you just learn real with your life? Like, yeah. Go get a trade. And I think that's great, Jess. I think it's great what you're doing. So really nice balance. And it wasn't until I was in my 20s that I first watched a movie that was titled Exit to the Gift Shop. And it's actually by a very well-known street artist, Wolf Banksy, and as well with Shepard Fairey. And I really liked the movie, really. It was the movie itself, maybe not so much the artists and their work, but the whole how it was portrayed, all the artists that were involved, and how they were just had this freedom to be able to express the art that they wanted to express, no matter how juvenile it seemed, or how it just looked like throw up, or or like the political backing, or whatever they believed in. It was like so great that they could just go out there and create this. So in 2011, I had my first gallery show at the Nanaimo Art Gallery, and it was actually a street art show that I was invited to participate in, and it really solidified the fact that I was really welcome in that art world, and although like being in Poland and seeing the galleries there, and I wanted to cry at realism because of its beauty, not who I am necessarily, or where I find my ability to express. So I was happy to be able to find a home inside of this sort of urban genre and to be able to continue to associate and be part of a community that gives such freedom socially and emotionally and everything else. So I just totally switched.
Days of waste and nights of toothpaste taste. Art to me is a god. a lazy bastard god who summoned me to do his dirty work. A god who gets with one hand and taketh the way with two. I can only talk about my own experiences, my own filth, my own wiltering and wallowing like some sick and diseased pig in meat, a glutton of punishment and sorrow. Years of groveling and apologizing, some kind of strange, endangered monkhood, always trying to get the next show, always trying to get the next fix. My best advice to those depraved enough to follow this path is not to get excited about it, not to get your hopes up, rather reject the failure, find a juicy fat vein and mainline it, fill your veins with pain, live on pancakes and toothpaste, smear yourself across the now stained glass of life. I censored that. As they said, smear yourself with a part of your body. Now, you might find this hard to believe, but I haven't always been this positive and successful. I once was a lowly heavy metal janitor back there in the frozen desert. You may have seen me, or at least some of my ilk. A tattered Slayer shirt, spiraling human waste, headphones on, singing the lines of my own song. How long will this go on? That also might be a question at your head this morning. If I could pinpoint the exact moment I decided to be an artist, would be the moment art chose me, in fact. Art chose me on a cold and gory prairie parking lot at exactly 6:18 a.m. Fingertips frozen, eyelashes laced with icicles, hungover, sick, beaten down, industrial-sized broom and dustpan in my hand, bending down at work, cleaning frozen filth. A note, a badly scrawled note, fluttering, not unlike that of a butterfly that made the drastic decision to rip off half of its wings to escape death from a frozen puddle of mucus. Forgot what I was talking about. Oh yes, a note. I don't like this one. There it was flirting with me, wanting to give me a paper cut. And you know what that note said? Well, the odd did. You went there. The note said, "Sorry, Wayne, someone puked in the cab last night, and I didn't have time to clean it up." I thought about that note for a while. So now that I think of it, that really has nothing to do with this. However, it was that day that my boss yelled at me and said I wasn't showing enough initiative cleaning up the dirt. That was the moment I said I'd quit. Then he said to me, "Oh yeah? Well, what are you going to do?" I said, "I'm going to rock!" Well, in a perfect world, I would have said that. I actually said I didn't even argue. I showed him. I wish I could also actually say that I quit that moment, but it didn't say something in me of why I said that. Why did I pick artists? I knew nothing of art. I thought Picasso was from the same time as Michelangelo, and he, of course, was a ninja turtle. Later that week, oddly enough, he got a contract with an art gallery to wax the floor. A public art gallery, not an office. A gallery of frozen problems called the Mentor. As I stood in the gallery alone with a slop pail, looking at the art and walls, I thought to myself, I can do this. And then I didn't print the rest of the thing. I can do this. I'm going to do an art show at the AGV on October the 5th, 2016. But then I got that wrong because time machines aren't always accurate. It's actually October the 6th. But I was lying one day off. That was 1993, so it's pretty good that I know. Thanks.
Thanks for everyone for coming. Appreciate it. And everyone has a great night. Enjoy. two large pieces in the room there. One is Wonder Woman, and there's another Caravaggio knockoff, I guess you'd call it. Most of my work has got an idea, shoot some reference photos, and away. I was lucky enough to have two pieces in the show, so I'm really grateful. Alongside a bunch of other talented artists, so yeah, thanks everybody. Have a great night. Yeah, I guess I'll meet you all as you come in the hallway, making your way to the Master Gallery area. I did a large triptych of East Hastings. I spent 2 days on Hastings and shot a bunch of photos, mainly from the hip. But anyways, collage them all together, and then made this large East Hastings piece, featuring a couple of like my favorite bars, a few greasy spoon diners, and a classic like East Hastings Dirty Alley. Combine all the photos together and create this large triptych. It's 144 inches by 96 tall, so it's quite large, and it's getting installed in there.
October 19th, everyone. Hopefully then, fingers crossed, it will be installed in our new feature hall that's just going in between the permanent exhibition space and the Spencer Mansion.
Okay.